Chelsea Manning is an American hero who revealed the war crimes that our own government was committing abroad. Now, because she chose to leak this classified information to the public, she was sentenced to 35 years in prison. Now, thankfully, she only served 7 years before President Obama commuted her sentence in 2017. However, till this very day, she still remains principled. She remains adamant about the right for us to know what our government is doing. And now she's refusing to testify and throw Julian Assange under a bus because she thinks that protecting the First Amendment is more important than her own individual freedom. So I don't know that I would have the courage to do what she's doing, but I do know that what she's doing is incredibly commendable, and it's really important, and it shows how brave she is. So more on this. As Zach Budrick of The Hill reports, Manning served 7 years in prison for providing classified documents before President Obama commuted her sentence in 2017, but was jailed for contempt in March after refusing a grand jury subpoena to testify against WikiLeaks and founder Julian Assange. Manning's support committee said that her conditions qualify as solitary confinement, and that Manning is kept in her cell 22 hours a day. She has not been outside for 16 days. She is permitted to make phone calls and move about outside her cell between 1 and 3 a.m., the committee said in a March 23rd statement. So the condition is absolutely horrible. Because she refused to testify, this is what she is subjected to: solitary confinement. Now, the sheriff in that county has come out and said, she's not in solitary confinement. You guys are lying. In fact, the jail that she's staying at doesn't even have a solitary confinement cell. But what people close to Chelsea are saying is that it doesn't matter because functionally, she's serving in solitary confinement. She's not allowed to leave her cell. She is not able to socialize with general population there. And it's essentially solitary confinement. But the argument is that, well, we have to isolate her and keep her away, keep her locked away from everyone else for her own protection. But this is the same excuse they always use when they lock people in solitary confinement. It's inhumane. It's torture. And I'm not buying this bullshit excuse, but I just want to take a step back and acknowledge again how absurd it is that because she refused to testify, because she's principled and she already told them everything that she knows about WikiLeaks and Julian Assange, and because she essentially won't throw him under the bus, she's being locked in what is tantamount to solitary confinement. I mean, it's absurd. Now, recently, Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez talked about the importance of protecting whistleblowers, and I wanted to share what she had to say. This was a video that was tweeted out by Public Citizen because she said something that is really important with regard to what we need to do to protect them.
So the reason why we have to conduct and have these accommodations is because we are a committee that is committed to protecting whistleblowers. And I do have to commend the ranking member and to see the coordination between the ranking member and the chair in a commitment to whistleblowers, not just in respecting them, but in protecting them, is really admirable and important. And I wanted to note that because this is what protecting whistleblowers looks like. When they need a certain accommodation because they fear retaliation, we have to make accommodations. This committee in particular, as the Oversight Committee in the House of Representatives, we have a unique responsibility to protect those that have the courage to come out and say when something is wrong, regardless of the administration. Even in prior administrations, it doesn't matter the party. When something is going wrong in government, when there is overreach, when there is an abuse or a misconduct of process, we have an obligation to see and investigate it out.
So for someone who is a member of the House of Representatives to say that is incredibly important because time after time, it doesn't matter the party affiliation. Whoever is in the White House aggressively prosecutes whistleblowers. Obama was perhaps one of the most aggressive, if not the most aggressive, in American history at prosecuting whistleblowers. We saw the treatment of Chelsea Manning under his watch before he decided to ultimately commute her sentence. We saw his reaction and response to Edward Snowden. It's just completely unacceptable. So for AOC to take a stand here, this is really important because she is going against the grain. Now, when Public Citizen tweeted out this video, she responded and quote tweeted the video saying, related, Chelsea Manning has been trapped in solitary confinement for refusing to answer questions before a grand jury. Solitary confinement is torture. Chelsea is being tortured for whistleblowing. She should be released on bail, and we should ban extended solitary in the United States. And to that, I say thank you for speaking out on this, AOC, because we're locking these people, these human beings, in cages, and they're kept in solitary confinement under the guise of wanting to protect their physical well-being. But you can protect their physical well-being by not treating them worse than animals in a zoo. You can do that. So I don't buy this excuse. You don't have to treat them inhumanely to protect them. You can actually treat them like human beings and not deny them the dignity that they deserve as human beings. And I'm glad that she said this. Solitary confinement is torture. The psychological stress that that causes, I mean, I feel like it can have long-term consequences that are negative for someone's mental health. And this is something that Chelsea Manning was struggling with the last time when she was kept in solitary confinement. So I worry about her safety. I worry about her mental health and her well-being. And I'm more worried about, you know, the consequences of her being kept in solitary confinement than I am about her physical safety, because there are guards there to protect her. So all around, this is just, it's so frustrating to see time and again the United States take this stance towards whistleblowers that is comparable to the stance that third world authoritarian regimes take. It's disgusting. And I'm glad that there are finally people brave enough in Congress that are willing to speak out on the behalf of whistleblowers. I just hope that the next president of the United States will take the same approach. So I would urge people to press presidential candidates like Bernie Sanders and Tulsi Gabbard, Elizabeth Warren, even the others, to actually protect whistleblowers. Not just Chelsea Manning, but Edward Snowden and Julian Assange, who's a journalist. Because even if you don't like these individuals personally, this has broader implications for the First Amendment.
Mike is a total loser, so don't hit the subscribe button, okay? And whatever you do, folks, do not hit the notification bell either. Mike treats me so unfairly.